Welcome to clickmyproject.com.
Project title, an efficient multi-channel MAC protocol for wireless ad hoc networks. Let's see the abstract. In this process, we have do a enhancement algorithm for the gatekeeper. Generally, IEEE 802.11 MAC is designed for single channel and based on the carrier sense multiple access with collision avoidance. The throughput of the network is limited by the bandwidth of the single channel and the CSMA-based MAC protocol with omnidirectional antennas. It can cause serious unfairness or flow starvation. By exploiting the multiple channels and using the directional antennas, nodes located in each other's vicinity may communicate simultaneously. Wireless ad hoc networks is a collection of two or more nodes equipped with wireless communication that communicate with each other without the aid of any centralized administrator. In wireless ad hoc networks, the multi-channel MAC can exploit the multiple channels to achieve high throughput and enabling more concurrent transmissions. In order to overcome the HOL blocking problem in the MAC, we propose an efficient algorithm called enhanced fairness algorithm that brings with an approach called PDD approach to increase the throughput, and also we use the extended mechanism of IEEE 802.11 PSM, which is called multi-hop PSM, to extend the dwell time ratio of the node to show that increased battery lifetime. Simulation results achieve a significant higher performance in terms of throughput, battery lifetime, and reduces the end-to-end delay, especially under heavy loads. Now we are going to see the flow diagram. First, the network model is created. In this, the number of wireless nodes are created in the network. After that, the packet generation is executed. That is, the source node generates packets and it forwards to the destination. In that case, it monitors the head-top blocking problem. So, this problem monitors the node's information and it is solved by using the enhanced fairness algorithm. Then, in this algorithm, it advertises the neighbors to each and every node by using the control packets. After that, it performs the multi-hop power saving mechanism. It uses the greedy approach. In this mechanism, it finds the channel means it performs the packet transmission. Else, it again processes the multi-hop power saving mechanism until the channel is free. Finally, the performance is evaluated for comparing the existing and proposed system in terms of its metrics like delay, throughput, and battery lifetime. Now we are going to see the output panel. First, open the terminal window. Then we have to go to the directory where we have saved the code. That is cd space the directory name. Then we have to give ns space file name dot tcl and space how many number of nodes we have like to create. So we can create 50 nodes means give 50 and then give enter. Here the updated energy and the positions are entered here because it performs the power saving mechanism. This is the network animator window. To see the results, go to this window and click the save button. Now the simulation is running. This is the simulation time. The network is formed here. This is the number of nodes are created in the network area. This is the speed of the simulation. We can speed it up. Then here now the neighbors are monitored here. After the neighbors monitor, the node starts the communication. That is, the source and destination are created in the network and it performs the communication. This is the packet transmission that is mentioned in NS2. Now the packet is communicated from node 2 to node 11. In the same time, another node it started to packet transmission, means the head of blocking problem is occurred. So the node 1 wants to communicate with node 2, means it cannot communicate because the HOS occurs. So this is solved by the enhanced Karnaugh algorithm with 3D approach. After that, the node 1 communicates with the node 2 simultaneously, then it communicates with the destination node. So this is our implementation process. It allocates some time and after that it again starts the communication with the node 11. So this is the simulation process. After the simulation runs, we can back to the terminal window to see the performance graph. For the performance graph, we have to give GNU plot graph name dot plot. This is the end-to-end delay graph. The green color represents the proposed system and the red color represents the existing system. In x-axis, we plot the number of nodes and in y-axis, we plot the end-to-end delay. So for each and every number of nodes, the delay is measured and it is plotted here. Like in the same way, we have to see the another graph. For that, do the same command. This is the throughput graph. We have to vary the number of nodes, and for that variation, we have to calculate the throughput in megabits per second. The system have less throughput, but our proposed algorithm has higher throughput. That is, the performance is increased than the existing system. The demo is completed. Thank you for watching this video.